Today on Two Crazy Ketos, we're going to do keto at Universal Studios Florida.
The Hogwarts Express is pulling out
right after this.
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
If you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like product reviews, we do recipe videos, we talk about various keto topics, and then every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com, and that's where to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Yeah. So we woke up this morning at 3 a.m.
We said, let's go to Universal Studios.
And made the drive from South Florida up here to Orlando, Florida to go to Universal Studios, Florida.
And it was worth getting up for.
Yeah, we have not been here in years. I want to say like at least 2010.
Yeah.
And we were talking about it on the way up. The last time we were here, I used to have to get on rides. Sometimes I couldn't even fit in a ride.
Or we had to get the extension seat.
Or I had to ask for the special seat. Like, you know, row number 2, seat number 3, that one where the seat belt's a lot bigger. That was my experience. So this is going to be very different for us to be here and not have to worry about fitting in a seat or exceeding the weight limit on a ride.
It's also the first time that we're doing this without a motorized scooter or wheelchair.
Yeah, so sorry it's a little loud. Oh,
there's
my God.
Dragon.
There's a dragon. So, yeah, like Rachel was saying, every time I've ever gone to a theme park since we were married, I had to have a wheelchair or a motorized scooter because of my ankle, because I have pins in my ankle. And for the first time ever, we're going to walk the entire park without any kind of wheelchair or anything.
A real victory lap.
This is huge for us. No handicap sticker, no wheelchair, no motorized scooter, because my arthritis, like, I don't have any more pain after starting keto 3 years ago.
Yeah, so I'm excited about not having to push you around.
So, yeah, so we're already here. We're going to walk around, and then we'll show you guys some different things. We'll talk about some of our tips for the new year and when you're coming to a theme park. And then we'll also show you some of our food choices while we eat here today.
Because you can eat keto when you're on vacation in an amusement park.
Yep. So follow us along today at Universal Studios Florida.
It's so weird not having kids. So I don't have like a ton of crap to carry.
Well, we do have one kid.
Yeah, but he doesn't make us like have to keep a diaper bag and toys and things for the line.
We're in Hogsmeade. There is Sirius Black over there looking so hot on his poster. Sorry, Joe.
We're gonna ride the Hogwarts Express. How about that? We're in Hogsmeade. I can't believe this is happening. I was asleep in South Florida like 3 hours ago, and now I'm in Hogsmeade. We are in Diagon Alley. How exciting!
So right now we're getting ready to ride on the Harry Potter Escape from Gringotts ride, and one of our secrets when we come to theme parks is to actually ride the single rider line, because there's a 45 minute wait right now, but for us it's less than 5 minutes.
It's not like you're gonna hang out and talk to each other when you're on the ride.
Boy, this ride brings back memories.
This is something that we rode all the time when the kids were really little. But I'd have one on one side, one on the other, and they'd want me to have my hands like this so they could cover their faces if they needed to, but open them up if they wanted to see.
So we spent a lot of time in the Barney section of Universal Studios when the kids were little, and now Rachel and Anthony are reliving Anthony's childhood as they play in the sand.
You sabotage. I was winning.
I have a 19-year-old who thinks he's, like, 4.
Oh, snap.
How much are you reminiscing the kid's childhood right now?
I want to cry right now because the kids were this little the last time we were here.
So it is about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. We're finally going to stop to eat.
We've almost walked 7 miles already.
Yes, we've walked like 7 miles, and we've been going since 3 a.m.
Yeah.
And it's amazing because, like, we're a little hungry, but not super hungry.
I'm not going to hurt somebody yet.
Yeah.
We don't want to push it.
So, but we have a lot of energy for, like, being on keto, having walked 7 miles up since 3 a.m., and we're going to eat now at, what is it, 20 after 1. And the best part is we've hit almost every single ride on this side
already.
It's been
awesome. I can't believe it during a holiday weekend or, you know, week.
Well, the key is single rider lines. We've hit the single rider lines on every single ride that we wanted to go on. And so the lines have been like 45, 50, 75 minutes long. We've been able to walk right in the ride within like 5 minutes.
Well, and a lot of times, even with a single rider line, we get to sit next to each other.
Yeah. So we're waiting for our food, and then we'll show you what we're eating today for lunch here. And then we'll probably grab something when we leave the park for dinner. Okay, so we got our burgers. Unfortunately, they don't do a whole bunch of special orders here because we're at one of like the little like serve and go burger places.
It's called Richter's Burger Company.
And we ordered through the app, so you can't even tell them like no bread, but this is what we got.
Burgers and fries.
Now that's okay, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna hand Anthony all of the fries. We're gonna take the bread off, and they have an incredible fixings bar.
Yeah.
So we can just kind of pile up some lettuce and some like pickles, things like that, that are keto friendly, and make a bunless burger ourselves. And to replace the fries, I bought a bag of the F-bomb cheese crisps, so we can use this kind of as our french fries.
Well, lunch was delicious.
Yeah, I'm stuffed. I mean, it was really good. I mean, it wasn't top quality food. I mean, let's face it, it was dirty keto. It had American cheese on it,
mm-hmm.
but it was the best option, and it was already super expensive, so I don't want to go to the place and spend $30, so.
Well, they had turkey legs, and that's definitely like a total keto thing to do, but I'm not a big fan of all the tendons on those giant turkey legs. We've bought them in the past and then gotten them and been like, yeah, not for me.
And then they also had like a chicken like salad. There was like chicken on a bed of lettuce. But we figured we'll just get the burger.
Yeah.
We're going to eat a little bit cleaner later on. Tomorrow we're just going to have wings. And then after that, it's 30 days of only eating keto chow and keto bread. So how bad could just one burger with a slice of American cheese and bacon be?
Not that bad, I don't think.
Now, one thing about Universal that's really cool is you can actually bring your own food in. I mean, we chose to not do it today because we wanted to see about like ketoing at some of the different restaurants. But you can bring in your own food, your own water, different things like that. So that's always an option if you come to Universal.
Well, and another reason why we didn't bring anything is because we wanted to experience it like parents of adult children.
Yeah.
Where you don't have to bring a ton of backpacks.
Yeah. So right now we're waiting for Anthony, who is getting a butterbeer.
And the line is ridiculous.
Yeah, the lines over here in the Harry Potter land are really ridiculous. I mean,
the new
ride is what, 240 minute wait, and earlier it was like 360 minutes.
We are not interested in waiting in line for 4 to 6 hours.
No.
So we're gonna come back with a fast pass.
Yeah, and if not, we will come up another day because that is one of the rides that opens up early. All we have to do is be here when the park, an hour before the park opens, and we can get in there then.
At some point, we saw that you could buy a fast pass for any time, but it was like $200 a ticket.
Just for the one day, in addition to your park entrance, it was $200 to be able to get on every ride without having to wait.
Who has money for that?
Not us.
Not us.
So we're going to finish waiting for Anthony, and while we're waiting for him, I'm going to keep working in my head how we could make a keto-friendly butterbeer. So we just got off a Hulk, and what a difference from the last time we were here. I mean, the last time we were here, I weighed 285 pounds.
Yeah, I mean, we rode it two times because we like ran back up the stairs. And one time you got to ride in a brand new seat that you've never sat in since they opened this ride.
That's right.
And then the next time we just, by lottery system, you happen to get
I
that
had to
seat.
Sit in the modified seat again. And that's the thing, is the last time I was here, I mean, it was like the walk of shame when you had to go up to them and say, can I have the seat with the double seat belt and everything so that for the big fat guy? And I mean, I've been on these rides where I couldn't fit at all. So what a different experience to be able to come here and not have to worry about that. And I just wish that I would have done this when my kids were little, where I could have really enjoyed these rides with them.
Yeah, same. It was a much different experience for me too, because I was heavy. You know, I didn't have to have the modified seat, but I was heavy going on these rides, and even just walking for the day, like, I feel great. We've walked like 10 miles already, more than that.
I mean, it is 5 o'clock. The only thing we've had is a hamburger, so maybe like 450, 500 calories tops a piece. And we're over 10 miles, and we've been up since 3 a.m.
Yeah.
You can only do a park like this on keto with that few calories. So we're going to go find some more rides. We'll check with you guys later on.
Tabitha is super excited to see us. She's a little crazy. Tabitha, what are you doing? Whoa! She knocked me down. Okay, calm down. Stop. 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 Go get her.
Well, we're back. And I look like I got hit by the Hogwarts Express. It's bad. I'm sorry. I look terrible.
Well, we're home. We got home last night at like 11:30. It's obviously Tuesday morning. It's New Year's Eve. And we just collapsed when we got home. I mean, it was a long day. We got up at 3 in the morning. It's a 3-hour drive to Orlando. We spent all day there. And then 3 hours home. So I just laid in bed. I don't even remember going to sleep.
I don't remember crossing the threshold of the front door. I may have slept in the front yard. I'm not sure.
I don't think there's anything better than theme park tired, with the exception of maybe like beach/boat tired.
Maybe like water slide park tired.
Yeah.
Yes. You're exhausted.
They just take it out of you and you get a good night's sleep. But it was a fun day. We had a lot of good times, brought back a lot of memories. It was nice going with Anthony. With our food, I mean, we showed you what we ate for lunch. Now, for dinner, we ended up just stopping at Wawa, and we got like a sub/salad bowl.
Because we could not pay another $65 for 3 hamburgers. We just couldn't do it.
Yeah, it was expensive to eat in the park, and I felt like you didn't get a lot. Now, we never used to eat in the park. We used to always bring our own food and even bring our own drinks. I mean, we usually would bring one of these big things filled with either water or soda, because I always had my motorized scooter, and we would just put it in the basket. So if you are going with somebody who has a motorized scooter, or even better, when you had the baby strollers.
Yes.
You get the baby stroller, and then you could put everything down in the bottom, like your food and stuff like that. That's how
baby.
We did it.
Have a baby, everybody.
Have a baby and go to Universal Studios.
So much worth. I mean, it really pays off as far as like the stroller availability during a theme park.
But what I would say is, yeah, so if you do go to like Universal Studios, now part of that $60 we spent for lunch is we got this cup. And the cup was like $16, but then it's like free refills through the entire day. And we just like would share it between the three of us. And now since we have annual passes, we can take it back and it's only $9 to fill each time we go.
That so seems like a value.
This is like a precious cup. Yeah, because it's $5 for a drink.
$4
if you don't.
For a bottle of water.
Yeah. So for us, it wasn't worth it. We were like, we'll just do this and just everybody can keep getting drinks. But what I would say is if you're going to Universal Studios and...
pack your lunch.
Yeah, need food. Pack your lunch. Or if you're not going to carry your lunch in like a backpack or something like that. Well, first of all, with keto, you could just fast. I really could have just fasted all day. It was just Anthony wanted to eat. And then you start thinking about like, hey, food.
Well, and it's funny because the last time we were there, we weren't keto.
Right.
And it's amazing. Again, it's like a habit thing. So I could tell you, okay, I could go for a snack right here. I could go for something for lunch right here. And it's totally based on memories of being in the park and thinking, hey, this is about the ride that we normally eat something.
Right.
It had nothing to do with me being hungry. It had everything to do with the smells they were piping in, the memories that I have of going with the kids. And this is the point where their whining intersected with my hangriness, and we went ahead and broke down and ate something here.
Right.
So that was interesting to think about that. Yeah,
but we did go the entire day from like 3 a.m. until like when we left. Well, no, when we left at 8 o'clock.
Oh.
basically only eating about 450 calories.
Yeah.
And I don't think I could have ever done that pre-keto.
I know I couldn't have.
But what I would say is if you've ever been to Universal Studios, if you're going to go and you absolutely want to stop and just maybe have a family meal like halfway through the day, my suggestion would be to exit out of the park and go to the restaurants that are on the outside in the City Walk area.
Yeah.
Because most of those restaurants are pretty reasonable. They're not... The prices aren't the inside the theme park prices where you're paying like $19 for a fast food hamburger.
Yeah.
You can custom do your food. They have like the Hard Rock Cafe, the NBC restaurant, things like that, where you can get a burger. You can tell them substitute broccoli for the fries. You're not going to pay much more than you would pay in the theme park. You'd probably even pay less and get much more food and be a little bit more comfortable. And all you got to do is exit out of the park and walk right back in.
Well, and here's the thing. Food is much more precious to me. The whole experience of food is different now for me. And one of the things that struck me was watching people eating this overpriced food that wasn't like top shelf.
Right.
In a very cramped atmosphere. I mean, people eating Cinnabon and it was like their leg was up over their head and they were, you know, crushed into places. And it's like, I would rather now just wait until I can sit down and enjoy the moment. So don't force yourself within the park to eat like a bunch of sardines, some right. overpriced food.
Overall, it was a great day. I mean, the park was packed. Every ride had like 90-minute to 2-hour waits. And we just hit the fast pass lines, or not the fast pass lines.
Single rider.
The single rider lines on just about every single ride. And we always ended up sitting, at minimum, in the same car. Maybe Rachel in one row, me in another row, and Anthony in another row. But we were sitting together on pretty much every ride, only now the average wait time was 5 minutes. We had one ride that didn't have a single rider line, and I think that wait was like 40 minutes, and we just stood talking. So it was a great day, and we hit every ride with the exception of three.
The Hagrid ride, which we'll have to go back for.
Which was a 6-hour wait.
I'm just not waiting that long. The King Kong.
Yeah. Because it broke down right when we got up to there. We were, like, getting on there, like, broken down for hours.
And there was, like, a Sinbad ride.
Oh, that's an experience. But then there was one other ride. Oh, the Mummy. We didn't get we didn't get on the Mummy. Because, again, it broke down when we got there.
Right.
But what do you expect? I mean, the park was packed. It was, like, a holiday weekend.
But I definitely would, you know, recommend that whatever theme park that you're going to, look and see if they have a single rider line, because you're still talking to your party in the line. Once you get on the ride, you're not talking anyway.
Well, that is our video for today, our little theme park vlog.
Well, before we exit, I wanted to share something.
Oh, that's right. Because you may notice in the video,
how bad
Rachel was wearing a hat.
Now, I usually wear a hat or something like that in the theme park because I do not have Herbal Essence shampoo commercial hair, no matter what.
We always have talked about, like, people who go to the theme park and their hair has to be perfect. You're going on roller coasters.
My hair
is going to blow around.
It's going to look crazy after the first ride. However, my hair has been experiencing some crazy growth. So usually I can go about 45 to 60 days before I dye my hair.
Yep.
I'm just waiting for me to get a little bit of the grays come in, and then I will dye my hair. Well, I started actually using, no joke, religiously, this Perfect Keto Collagen in November, and oh my goodness, it is super embarrassing.
Yeah.
Let me show you guys.
I'll show you guys this. I can't believe you're even going to do this.
I know. This is awful.
But look at this. I mean, she's got like an inch of hair growth in the last like 45 days.
It is super embarrassing. And if I had any sense, I would not show this on camera. But I'm hoping that although it's embarrassing, it will be helpful, because I didn't know if I was going to grow good hair ever again.
Yeah, that's something. I mean, if you've been watching our channel for a while, Rachel is always talking about, she's like, cover my bald spot, which it's not a bald spot. It's just like super thin
cowlick.
Hair and
yeah.
a cowlick and everything. But it's something she's always been sensitive about since she started doing the collagen. And
look at that. I mean, and it's all throughout. Like, I have it in the front here. Usually it's just here that I'll experience some growth. But I mean, it is all through my bangs, all on the sides. I was doing my makeup the other day and I thought, did I get some foundation in my hair? No, it was solid white hairs all through here. Super embarrassing, but also that means that I'm growing my hair,
yeah,
which is awesome.
Well, that is our video for today. We're going to go color Rachel's hair right now.
Yes.
Let us know down in the comment section if you ever go to theme parks, what your favorite theme parks are and what some of your food options are when you're on the ketogenic lifestyle.
Also, are you a roller coaster enthusiast like me, or do you like to keep your feet on the ground?
Please do us a favor and hit that like button down below.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time I look like a hot mess, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye.
Bye.